Thomas and Fergus, the traction engine, are friends. Fergus is the pride of the cement works. He knows all the rules and obeys them. One day, the fat controller brought devious Diesel to the cement works. I need Diesel to help for a while. Please show him around.
Yes, said Fergus unhappily. He knew that Diesel could be trouble.
Later, Diesel was being careless.
Not like that, snapped Fergus. Do it right.
Don't interfere, sneered Diesel.
You don't know the rules, retorted Fergus.
Diesel was very annoyed with Fergus and started plotting a devious plan. Later that day, he pretended to have news for Fergus.
The fat controller wants you to work at the smelters.
Me? But I'm the pride of the cement works.
Not anymore. The fat controller says I'm better than you, so I'm going to stay here.
It's not fair. I love working here.
But he knew that really useful engines have to do as they are told. Fergus and his driver arrived at the smelters.
I want to go back to the cement works, wailed Fergus. None of the other engines like coming here. It's so scary.
You're right, said his driver. Just then, the scrap Diesels arrived.
Hello, are you happy to be here?
No, cried Fergus.
His driver was scared too.
Come on, Fergus, we're going to escape.
For the first time, Fergus broke the rules. The fat controller was enjoying a tasty supper of kippers when he heard that Fergus was missing.
That's not like Fergus. There must be something wrong. I will send Thomas to look for him.
Fergus and his driver turned onto a disused track to find a place to hide. Fergus was frightened. So was Thomas. He puffed up and down the line. He couldn't see Fergus anywhere.
We could search the old mine track, said his driver.
That line is dark and spooky, whispered Thomas.
But he had to be brave and find Fergus. Fergus was on a siding. His fire had gone out. Then it happened.
It's an engine, he cried.
Fergus, whistled Thomas. Whatever are you doing out here?
Hiding. Don't want to work at the smelters. The fat controller is going to be cross with me.
He's not, cried Thomas. He's worried about you.
Really?
Of course, puffed Thomas.
Fergus felt better. Thomas pulled Fergus all the way to the smelter's yard, where he knew the fat controller was waiting.
Fergus, explain yourself.
I ran away. It's scary here.
Diesel told Fergus that you wanted him at the smelters forever, said Thomas.
Nonsense, Fergus. You are the pride of the cement works. I shall send Diesel to the smelters and you can go back to the cement works tomorrow.
Oh, thank you, sir, said Fergus happily.
Fergus knew he had a good friend in Thomas, and he was still the pride of the cement works.
Was an engine who ran away, just up and
Fergus and Fergus, the traction engine, are friends. Fergus is the pride of the cement works. He knows all the rules and obeys them. One day, the fat controller brought devious Diesel to the cement works.
I need Diesel to help for a while. Please show him around.
Yes, said Fergus unhappily. He knew that Diesel could be trouble. Later, Diesel was being careless.
Not like that, snapped Fergus. Do it right.
Don't interfere, sneered Diesel.
You don't know the rules,
retorted Fergus. Diesel was very annoyed with Fergus and started plotting a devious plan. Later that day, he pretended to have news for Fergus.
The fat controller wants you to work at the smelters.
Me? But I'm the pride of the cement works.
Not anymore. The fat controller says I'm better than you, so I'm going to stay here.
It's not fair. I love working here. But he knew that really useful engines have to do as they are told. Fergus and his driver arrived at the smelters.
I want to go back to the cement works,
wailed Fergus.
None of the other engines like coming here. It's so scary.
You're right, said his driver. Just then, the scrap diesels arrived.
Hello, are you happy to be here?
No,
cried Fergus. His driver was scared too.
Come on, Fergus, we're going to escape.
And for the first time, Fergus broke the rules. The fat controller was enjoying a tasty supper of kippers when he heard that Fergus was missing.
That's not like Fergus. There must be something wrong. I will send Thomas to look for him.
Fergus and his driver turned onto a disused track to find a place to hide. Fergus was frightened. So was Thomas. He puffed up and down the line. He couldn't see Fergus anywhere.
We could search the old mine track, said his driver.
That line is dark and spooky, whispered Thomas, but he had to be brave and find Fergus. Fergus was on a siding. His fire had gone out. Then it happened.
It's an engine, he cried.
Fergus,
whistled Thomas. Whatever are you doing out here?
Hiding. Don't want to work at the smelters. The fat controller is going to be cross with me.
He's not, cried Thomas. He's worried about you.
Really?
Of course, puffed Thomas. Fergus felt better. Thomas pulled Fergus all the way to the smelter's yard, where he knew the fat controller was waiting.
Fergus, explain yourself.
I ran away. It's scary here.
Diesel told Fergus that you wanted him at the smelters forever, said Thomas.
Nonsense, Fergus. You are the pride of the cement works. I shall send Diesel to the smelters, and you can go back to the cement works tomorrow.
Oh, thank you, sir, said Fergus happily.
Fergus knew he had a good friend in Thomas, and he was still the pride of the cement works.
Was an engine who ran away.
Fergus, the traction engine, are friends. Fergus is the pride of the cement works. He knows all the rules and obeys them. One day, the Fat Controller brought Devious Diesel to the cement works.
I need Diesel to help for a while. Please show him around.
Yes,
said Fergus unhappily. He knew that Diesel could be trouble. Later, Diesel was being careless.
Not like that, snapped Fergus. Do it right.
Don't interfere, sneered Diesel.
You don't know the rules, retorted Fergus.
Diesel was very annoyed with Fergus and started plotting a devious plan. Later that day, he pretended to have news for Fergus.
The Fat Controller wants you to work at the smelters.
Me? But I'm the pride of the cement works.
Not anymore. The Fat Controller says I'm better than you, so I'm going to stay here.
It's not fair. I love working here.
But he knew that really useful engines have to do as they are told. Fergus and his driver arrived at the smelters.
I want to go back to the cement works, wailed Fergus. None of the other engines like coming here. It's so scary.
You're right, said his driver. Just then, the scrap diesels arrived.
Hello, are you happy to be here?
No, cried Fergus.
His driver was scared too.
Come on, Fergus, we're going to escape.
And for the first time, Fergus broke the rules. The Fat Controller was enjoying a tasty supper of kippers when he heard that Fergus was missing.
That's not like Fergus. There must be something wrong. I will send Thomas to look for him.
Fergus and his driver turned onto a disused track to find a place to hide. Fergus was frightened. So was Thomas. He puffed up and down the line. He couldn't see Fergus anywhere.
We could search the old mine track, said his driver.
That line is dark and spooky, whispered Thomas,
but he had to be brave and find Fergus. Fergus was on a siding. His fire had gone out. Then it happened.
It's an engine, he cried.
Fergus,
whistled Thomas. Whatever are you doing out here?
Hiding. Don't want to work at the smelters. The Fat Controller is going to be cross with me.
He's not, cried Thomas. He's worried about you.
Really?
Of course, puffed Thomas.
Fergus felt better. Thomas pulled Fergus all the way to the smelter's yard, where he knew the Fat Controller was waiting.
Fergus, explain yourself.
I ran away. It's scary here.
Diesel told Fergus that you wanted him at the smelters forever, said Thomas.
Nonsense, Fergus. You are the pride of the cement works. I shall send Diesel to the smelters and you can go back to the cement works tomorrow.
Oh, thank you, sir, said Fergus happily.
Fergus knew he had a good friend in Thomas and he was still the pride of the cement works.
Was an engine who ran away, just up and went, ran away, stop.
Fergus the traction engine are friends. Fergus is the pride of the cement works. He knows all the rules and obeys them. One day, the Fat Controller brought Devious Diesel to the cement works.
I need Diesel to help for a while. Please show him around.
Yes,
said Fergus unhappily. He knew that Diesel could be trouble. Later, Diesel was being careless.
Not like that, snapped Fergus. Do it right.
Don't interfere, sneered Diesel.
You don't know the rules,
retorted Fergus. Diesel was very annoyed with Fergus and started plotting a devious plan. Later that day, he pretended to have news for Fergus.
The Fat Controller wants you to work at the smelters.
Me? But I'm the pride of the cement works.
Not anymore. The Fat Controller says I'm better than you, so I'm going to stay here.
It's not fair. I love working here.
But he knew that really useful engines have to do as they are told. Fergus and his driver arrived at the smelters.
I want to go back to the cement works,
wailed Fergus.
None of the other engines like coming here. It's so scary.
You're right, said his driver. Just then, the scrap diesels arrived.
Hello, are you happy to be here?
No,
cried Fergus. His driver was scared too.
Come on, Fergus, we're going to escape.
And for the first time, Fergus broke the rules. The Fat Controller was enjoying a tasty supper of kippers when he heard that Fergus was missing.
That's not like Fergus. There must be something wrong. I will send Thomas to look for him.
Fergus and his driver turned onto a disused track to find a place to hide. Fergus was frightened. So was Thomas. He puffed up and down the line. He couldn't see Fergus anywhere.
We could search the old mine track, said his driver.
That line is dark and spooky,
whispered Thomas. But he had to be brave and find Fergus. Fergus was on a siding. His fire had gone out. Then it happened.
It's an engine,
he cried.
Fergus,
whistled Thomas.
Whatever are you doing out here?
Hiding. Don't want to work at the smelters. The Fat Controller is going to be cross with me.
He's not, cried Thomas. He's worried about you.
Really?
Of course, puffed Thomas.
Fergus felt better. Thomas pulled Fergus all the way to the smelter's yard, where he knew the Fat Controller was waiting.
Fergus, explain yourself.
I ran away. It's scary here.
Diesel told Fergus that you wanted him at the smelters forever, said Thomas.
Nonsense, Fergus. You are the pride of the cement works. I shall send Diesel to the smelters and you can go back to the cement works tomorrow.
Oh, thank you, sir, said Fergus happily.
Fergus knew he had a good friend in Thomas, and he was still the pride of the cement works.